Hi, today we will discuss microorganisms, a lesson for 8th standard. What do we mean by the microorganism? These are the tiny organisms which we cannot see by unaided eyes. To see them, we need a special instrument called the microscope. This is the picture of microscope. Is generally used to observe the microorganisms. Where do these microorganisms live? Microorganisms are omnipresent, means they present everywhere, as they can survive in every type of the environment. For example, they are found in water, air, soil, inside and outside of the plant and animal body, in the dead and decaying organic matter, etc. And do you know, they can even survive in the extreme condition that prevails in the desert, that is a very hot climate, equators, hot and humid climate, freezing water bodies like in the polar region, etc. And they can adapt accordingly and survive there. And this, as I told, microorganisms are found everywhere except the vacuum. They are not present in the vacuum in the space. Do you know these tiny creatures are also different types? There are the 5 types of the microorganisms: bacteria, algae, fungi, protozoa, and viruses. Let me understand these types in the detail. First one, the bacteria. Bacteria is a plural word and singular is the bacterium. These are unicellular organisms. Unicellular means the organism made up of single cells. And all these bacteria are unicellular organisms. They are either autotrophic, the few bacteria like it is sulfur bacteria and the green bacteria, they are autotrophic bacteria. But most of the bacteria are heterotrophic, and these heterotrophic bacteria are either saprophytic, that is growing on the dead decaying matter, or few are causing the diseases. But most of the bacteria are useful or harmless, and only few are harmful, causing the diseases. Depending upon their shape, there are the 3 subtypes of the bacteria. Spherical bacteria are known as cocci, and this may be the they are living single like monococcus, or they may live in the group like diplococci is 2 organism, staphylococci is a bunch of the spherical bacteria, streptococci is many bacteria present in the chain, tetrad means 4 bacteria and live in the together. Second is the rod-shaped bacteria known as the bacilli or singular bacillum. They are also found either single or in the chain called the streptobacilli. And then the third type is the spiral bacteria, because they have the spiral shape, and in that also you can see the if the half spiral is there, it is called vibrio. Complete spiral, the spiral bacteria is there. Next is the fungi. Fungi is either unicellular or multicellular. But it is multicellular also, not very big, it is a small creature. Unicellular fungi example is yeast. Multicellular fungi are mushroom, mold, etc. In the case of the mold, then are they having the thin fiber like structure, and these are called the hyphae, and it will be inside the substratum, that is the food material on which it is growing. And these fungi are heterotrophic. All the fungi are heterotrophic. They cannot make their own food. Most of the fungi are saprophytes. They grow on the dead and decaying matter. There are the few fungi which are parasitic, which lives on are inside the body of other living organism and causing the diseases to them. Next is algae. Alga is a singular word and algae is a plural. These are either unicellular or multicellular organism. Unicellular algae is like Chlamydomonas. Multicellular simple example is a Spirogyra. Algae are green color. They belongs to the plant group. They have the chlorophyll pigment, and because of that, all the algae are autotrophic in nature. Algae are useful as they prepare their own food. They are autotroph. They are the first organism in the food chain, and all other organisms like heterotrophs are depending upon them for their food, particularly aquatic organism. Algae is an aquatic organism found in the water body that plays a very important role in the aquatic ecosystem. And almost algae is harmless, but nowadays because of the water pollution, one of the harm the algae is causing is the eutrophication. Next group of the organism is a protozoa. They are unicellular and belongs to the animal group. They cannot prepare their own food. They are heterotrophic nutrition, and most common example of a protozoa is amoeba, euglena, paramecium, etc. Viruses. And these are the smallest creatures, and these are much more smaller than even bacteria also. And I know all of you can able to relate the viruses, because now today from this past 1.5 year, the whole world is troubled with this one of the viral disease called COVID-19. And one peculiar thing about the virus, though always there is the argument in the biologist whether viruses are living or non-living, because viruses are not made up of the cell. They are made up of just the two material, that is the nucleic acid, either DNA or RNA, and the protein coat. Only these two cells. And when the viruses are there outside, they don't show any sign of the living organism. They neither breathe, need the nutrition, then nor they need the, they excrete, no growth, nothing. But only when the viruses enter the host body, host cell, they start reproducing. And the reproduction is the only characteristic shown by the viruses which belongs to the living organism. And that's why many a time the biologists will keep the viruses in the borderline of both living and non-living creature. These viruses are harmful. They causes the diseases in the human being, plants, animal, and even to the bacteria also they cause the disease. Let me see a little activity to show the presence of microorganism in the air. You have to take the piece of the bread, dip it in the water to make it moist, and keep it aside for few days. And after few days you will see the bread mold will grow. It is like white cottony structure, and leave it for 1 or 2 days, you will see the black color powder, and you just touch the finger, you feel that black powder stick to your finger. That is nothing but the spores. To show the presence of microorganism in water, collect some water from the water bodies like pond or lake and observe under the microscope. Third is to show the presence of microorganism in the soil. Take the little soil sample from the garden nearby, add it in water, shake it properly, and then that allow the soil to settle down. Upper water, take it, observe the drop of water in the under the microscope, and you will see a lot of microorganism in that. Yeah. Now, as I told you, most of the microorganisms are harmless to us. And in fact, some of the microorganisms are beneficial, useful to the human being. There are a lot of microorganisms, particularly the bacteria, when we are talking, they are very, very handful. They turn milk into the yogurt, produce cheese, and they are also present in our stomach, which help in the digestion of the food. Yes, this is the picture of making the curds from the milk. And you might be have seen your mother, she is setting the milk for making the curd. She take the warm milk and add the spoonful of the curd into the milk, and then she keep it for overnight or for few hours undisturbed in the warm place, you observe that this milk had turned to the curd. How this is happening? Curd contain the bacteria lactobacillus. When she add the spoonful of the curd into the milk, this lactobacillus start growing. Milk contain lactose sugar, and this lactobacillus convert this lactose sugar into the lactic acid, and that is how this milk get precipitated and become the thick. Making of the cheese from the butter by processing with the bacteria, either the lactobacillus or streptococcus, this butter is converted into the cheese. For making bread, idli, dosa, dhokla, batter, there is a unicellular fungi called the yeast is used. For the bread and for making the cake, pastries, the bakers add this yeast powder. But you might be wondering, at home the mother is not adding yeast powder to make the batter of the dosa, idli or dhokla. But as I told, these organisms, microorganisms are everywhere. While making the batter, yes, these microorganisms start growing the yeast. Yeast is growing, and in the absence of the oxygen, its yeast will convert to the anaerobic respiration, carbon dioxide is released, and because of that carbon dioxide, this batter becomes fluffy. It will become the bigger in size. And when we are cooking it, because of the heat, this carbon dioxide escape, and that the food get the spongy texture. Yes, the yeast is also used for making the pizza base. Next, when we are talking commercial use of the microorganism, and microorganisms are used for making the alcoholic beverages, and this will happen with the anaerobic respiration. Now, this specifically is called a fermentation. Fermentation is a process is in which organism convert carbohydrate such as a starch or the sugar into the alcohol or in the acid, and this happen into the anaerobic condition. You can see the products of fermentation: alcohol, wine, vinegar, etc. Microbes increase the fertility of the soil. Some of the bacteria which lives into the root nodules of the leguminous plant, for example Rhizobium bacteria, it will fix the atmospheric nitrogen, and this nitrogen is utilized by the leguminous plant, and again the extra fixed nitrogen will be in the soil, and thus the soil fertility increases. There are the some free living bacteria which are present in the soil, that is also fixing the atmospheric nitrogen. The second picture you are seeing here, the algae, the particularly cyanobacteria or blue green algae, and generally these are used into the paddy field which fix the atmospheric nitrogen. There are the few microorganisms are the edible, Like as I told, yeast is used to make the food preparation, like the bread, cheese, bread. It is used in making of the pastries, dosa, idli, dukla batter, pizza base, and all thing. Mushrooms are edible. Few varieties of the mushrooms are edible, not all. And some of the algae, multicellular algae, which is known as the seaweed. These are also the edible. Then next, when we talk about the useful microorganism, particularly the bacteria and the fungi, which are saprophytic, they are also known as the decomposer because they clean the environment. They grow on the dead and decaying matter, and they decomposes that dead decaying matter into the simple inorganic substance, and thus helping into the cycle of this nutrients, like the nutrients which are present in the living organism, it will again release in the inorganic form into the environment. Microbes are also useful into the sewage treatment, particularly the bacteria. You have studied in the previous year the wastewater treatment. After the primary treatment, where the from the wastewater, after the sedimentation, filtration of the wastewater, the water is released into the aeration tank, where the air is released, and there the aerobic bacteria grows on the human feces, and then they will be converted to the activated sludge, and activated sludge will settle down, and the upper clarified water is transferred to the another tank where it is get chlorinated. So you can understand the bacteria plays a very important role in the sewage treatment also. Then anaerobic bacteria are used for in the biogas plant. Biogas plant, here the waste, particularly the agriculture waste, like cow dung and all thing, animal dungs and all thing, these are used to produce the biogas, that is a methane gas, in the closed chamber where anaerobic condition is maintained. Biogas is containing the methane gas, which is the component of both LPG and CNG also. And this biogas which is produced is used for the cooking purpose at the household, or to generate the electricity also. Generally in the India, the villages, the biogas plants are very common. But nowadays in the cities also we are seeing the biogas plants, particularly where the sewage water is used for production of the biogas. Next, when we are talking, microorganisms like bacteria and fungi are used for the preparation of antibiotics. Antibiotics, anti means against, biotics means living organism. This antibiotics kills or stops the growth of microorganism, particularly the bacteria. Few of the antibiotics are used against the fungi also. And this discovery of the antibiotics by the Alexander Fleming in the 1929, it has revolutionized the treatment of the diseases. This is the picture of Alexander Fleming and his experiment, what he had done with the streptococcus, and where the penicillium fungi grown, and you can see this round circle where the penicillium had grown, and it had the around that the streptococcus was not able to grow. Next, when we are talking about the uses of the microorganism, there are many disease causing microorganisms nowadays are used to in the preparation of the vaccines, and you can able to recall the most important vaccine now, the COVID-19 vaccine. It is under the lot of research, and the without making the trials, not much extensive medical trial, now it is administered to the many people. Yeah, तो व्हेन वी टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस वैक्सीन्स, हाउ दिस आर द वैक्सीन्स आर वर्किंग. वैक्सीन्स आर द सब्सटेंसेस विच आर प्रोड्यूस बाय द माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म आइदर लाइव और लाइव एंड द वीक और द डेड माइक्रो ऑर्गेनिज्म विच कॉज द डिसीज आर यूज इन द प्रिपरेशन ऑफ द वैक्सीन. And once these vaccines are introduced into the body, they will boost our immunity. So how they are boosting our immunity? Let me understand. Before that, just understand the Edward Jenner. He discovered a vaccine for smallpox in 1798. And the vaccines are the substances used to produce immunity to diseases in the living body. Immunity is the ability of the body to resist the disease by natural or artificial means. Antibodies are the chemical or substances produced by white blood cells to fight the invader. Let me see how this our white blood cell fight with the this one microorganism. Yes, so you can see here. When the microorganism, whether natural way or introduced by these vaccines inside our body, when the WBCs recognize these pathogens, the microorganism which enter our body, they will attach them to that. It will engulf this by phagocytosis, and inside the like amoeba, it will make the like the vacuole inside that the bacteria is there, and the lysosome will get fused with this vacuole where the microorganisms are there. The enzymes present in the lysosome digest this microorganism, and this is how this our WBCs kill the pathogens or the microorganism enter our body. There is a one more way is this our WBCs fight. Once the microbes enter in our body, our WBCs are making the antibodies. These antibodies recognize the invaders and they attach to this microbes. And then when the antibodies are attached to microorganism, and then that antibodies send a signal to the white blood cell, which are protecting us, and this WBCs will engulf by phagocytosis this microbe and digest it and destroy it. Now how this antibodies mainly entering? So here we have to understand how the immunity is generated. Once the microorganism, any microorganism enter our body, as the WBCs are making the antibodies, and these antibodies have the our body have the memory. Our body have the memory particularly about that antibody and that microbe. Which type of the antibody can effectively kill that microbe. And this little amount of the antibodies will remain, and once the next time this microorganism enter our body, immediately this our immune system, the memory in our immune system can recognize it and kill it. And that is how the vaccines work. As I told in the vaccination, the vaccines contain the either weak or dead causative microorganism of particular disease. And as they are introduced in our body, but our body's immune system not recognize whether it is dead or living microbe. But it is, yes, it will recognize it is the foreign and it is the microorganism, and it will make the antibodies kill it. That is how this happened. And there are lot of diseases by vaccination which are under the control, like the smallpox is eradicated already. Polio is in the verge of eradication, and there are many diseases like hepatitis is there, then the BCG, and there are lot of vaccines are given, and you might be knowing as a children that you also might get now also any vaccines. And as I told you, COVID-19 vaccine is now the live example. Everybody, irrespective of their age, all of us are taking this vaccine to protect ourselves. Is the microorganism only the useful? No, there are few microorganisms which are harmful. These microorganisms spoil our food. They produce the toxin and spoil our food and leading to the food poisoning. Harmful microorganism can spoil our leather clothes, leather material, clothing, etc. And do you know the harmful microorganism causes disease in not only human being but also in animals and plants? These are the some few examples of the diseases caused by the different group of the organism in the human being. Like bacteria, they cause the typhoid, cholera, tuberculosis, anthrax, pimples, peptic ulcer, etc. Viruses cause the common cold, influenza, dengue fever, SARS, AIDS, and recent COVID-19. Fungi, they causes the mainly the skin infections like ringworm, athlete's foot, etc. Protozoa, they causes different diseases like malaria, kalaza, sleeping sickness, amoebic dysentery, etc. And the algae are not causing the any diseases particularly other than the eutrophication, but that is actually the we will discuss in the subsequent lesson, but not this in much. You can see this the list of the diseases caused by the microbes in the plant. Like the citrus canker is caused by the bacteria and it is the airborne spreading. Rust of wheat by the fungi. Yellow vein, mosaic of windy, etc. caused by the viruses. Second table, you are able to see the various diseases caused by microorganism, particularly the bacteria in the animals like anthrax, brucelliosis, bovine tuberculosis, black leg, etc. Spoilage of the food, as I told you, is one of the harmful effect of the microorganisms. If we keep the food for a long period of time before it is eaten, it may get spoiled. Now there are the two reasons of the spoilage of the food. It is not only by the microorganism, but one is the food gets spoiled because it is oxidized by the air. Second cause is it acted by the decomposers like bacteria and fungi. Now how come you know that food is spoiled? There are the three things are there. One thing, spoiled food emits the foul smell. The smell is very foul. Second, the taste of the spoiled food is very bad or there is a soreness developed in the spoiled food. Third, the color of the spoiled food may change. So these are the three simple methods we can know the food is spoiled. If the microbes or by oxidation food is getting spoiled, then how can we preserve the food for the longer duration to avoid the spoilage of food? There are the different methods are used for food preservation. One method, it kills the microorganism present in the food. Second method is to stop the microorganism from growing again. What are the advantages of food preservation? It will reduce the wastage of food due to the spoilage. It increases the shelf life of food items. It ensures food availability during off seasons and distant places. And it maintains the nutritional value and flavor of the food. And that's why food preservation is very, very important. What are the different methods of food preservation? Drying or dehydration, removing of the water. Drying is nothing but a simple removing of the water. Boiling, refrigeration and freezing, pasteurization, salting and adding sugar, use of chemicals, canning, etc. Let you can see the picture. The first thing, the drying, particularly the drying when we are talking the most of the drying is nothing but the removal of the water, and it is done mainly generally about the food grains and all thing. It is done the drying and in the sunlight, the most commonly in the sunlight. But in the factories they use the heat also for drying the food material. Second method is boiling the food, giving the heat treatment. So you can see the picture, the milk is boiled or the food we are boiling. When we are cooking the food, most of the time we boil the food to kill the microorganism. Boiling will be killing the microorganism. In the dairies, the food is milk. Mainly the milk is preserved by the pasteurization method. Pasteurization is not the boiling the milk, but the pasteurization is the heating the milk up to around 70 degrees Celsius, 65 to 70 degrees Celsius, and suddenly cooling the temperature, dropping the temperature to around 13 degrees Celsius. So when you are heating and then subsequently immediately cooling, because of the heat shock, this most of the microorganism present in the milk is killed. And this pasteurization technique is introduced by the scientist Pasteur, Louis Pasteur. Then by adding the salt and sugar also we can store the preserve the food. Most of the materials like the pickles, the fish, lot of salt is added for preservation. And like jams are there are the murabbas are there, and then the dried fruits are there. Mainly the sugar is added for the preservation. Adding the excess of the salt or sugar, it will dehydrate, remove the moisture content, and that is how the microbes are able to not grow into the food, and we can able to preserve the food for longer time. Then one other method is by adding the oil or vinegar to the food. You might be have seen in the pickles, a lot of oil is added, and the pickles which we buy from the outside, and that is lot of vinegar is added to the pickles, so that it will not get spoiled. Then after the drying, you can use one more method. That is, you can store this dried food item in the airtight container so the microbes cannot grow. One more method very commonly used at household, and that is the storing the food at a very low temperature in the refrigerators. At low temperature, both the spoilage by the spoilage of the food by the microorganism and oxidation or the by enzymes present in the food, that both will be prevented and food will be there for the longer duration. At commercial also, the huge cool storages are available to store the vegetables and the fruits which will be exported into the other countries. And one last method I just want to add up here, preservation of food by the adding the preservative. Different various food preservatives are there. These food preservatives are the chemicals which are added to the food and to store them for the longer duration. Most of the food, packaged food, ready to eat, soft drinks and all things, this most of this ready to eat food which are available in the packet form contain the preservative. So this is a little bit brief of this microorganism lesson. Thank you. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you very much.